Can you see my presentation?
Yes.
Okay. Hello, I am Tuan Nascimento, and we'll be presenting our work, investigating the use of future selection techniques for gender prediction system based on keystroke dynamics. This is a joint work with Adrianine Oliveira and my advisors, Laura Santana and Marjorie da Costa Abreu. The use of social networks grew enormously, serving to connect and share information among different groups of people. For example, Facebook, Instagram, WhatsApp, Telegram, and the others. However, users may be vulnerable to risky situations, for example, pedophilia. One of the ways to do the investigation of an alleged pedophilia is the validating whether the individual is in fact the gender that is said to be. For this a possible technique to be adopted is the keystroke dynamics. The keystroke dynamics is a behavioral biometric which consists of analyzing the way the user types in a terminal, monitoring the keyboard to identify the user based on his or her user type recent partners. Keystroke dynamics can be extracted through fixed text or free text. That is text that have been predetermined for all individuals under observation in the text that have a periodic monitoring of the keystroke respectively. This technique is accessible since in external hardware is not required to collect data from the keyboard only. Previous works present by that keystroke dynamics is a viable technique for gender recognition. However, this technique can extract many features and the dealing with a large amount of features can have a negative impact. It is common to think that the greater the number of features in data set, the easier it is to extract knowledge models. However, in practice, this may not be true, since there may be irrelevant or redundant features, and the presence of noise in it can confuse the classifier as well as impair its accuracy. In this way, the feature selection has been one of the main steps of the data processing for later applications in text, such as data mining, machine learning, pattern recognition, among others. Its main goal is to select a subset of relevant features among all the features available to the task. Feature selections can be done using a filter or upper approach. In the filter approach, the feature selection is performed independently of the classifier, taking into some evaluation metrics. The filter approach tends to select a larger number of features in its subsets and to have much a lower computational cost when compared to wrapper approach that uses the accuracy of the classifier to evaluate the subset of selected features. This requires high computational power, and we also have the hybrid approach, which is the combination of these two approaches. Thus, this work proposes performing a comparative analysis between meta-risk models performing a feature selection gender recognition using keystroke dynamics and the RAP approach with either particle swap optimization and the genetic algorithms and the two hybrid approach applying filters to rank the features in the step, the crossover of genetic algorithm and in the initial population respectively. Firstly, we need to understand the genetic algorithm work and then we present our proposed approach. In this flowchart, we present operation of the genetic algorithm, which is inspired by Darwin's theory of evolution. The genetic algorithm works in the following way. Firstly, randomly initial population is generated, then each individual of this population is evaluated using a fitness function. From the evaluation carried out, the fittest individuals are selected to continue in the genetic process. They are placed in temporary population, which can be called parents, and they are responsible for the next generation. This loop involving evaluation, selection, and the genetic operation is repeated until each ending condition. The first proposed genetic algorithm follows the entire flowchart described previously. However, the algorithm proposed in this work is the application of the correlation and the relief filters in the crossover step, where each filter was applied in a parent, returning a half the features of this filter. Considering the ranking generated by the filter, the child generated will be union the selected features of the two parents as crossover of two parents must generate two children maintain the size of population. This child was duplicated forming twins. Once these are done, the genetic algorithm follows its normal flow, verifying the mutation, which can cause the twins differentiated and adding the children to a new population. Thus, it's expected that with the application of the filters in the crossover step, there will be any crazy inaccuracy. In our second proposed approach, the application of the filters was developed in the initial population. Thus, the algorithm already starts with the best filters classified by filters, and it can result in the improvement of accuracy as will be described. In it, the algorithm follows the entire flowchart described previously. However, this approach presents the proposal of applying the correlation and the relief filter separately in the initial population of the genetic algorithm. Does each individual that composes the initial population already start with its rankings? The experiment was conducted in three stages using databases hand-based with 77 volunteers, 20 men, 50 women, 42 filters, and 221 instances. In the second database, GIOT, 133 volunteers, 98 men, 35 women, 60 filters, and 7,555 instances, as classifier KNN, SVM, and the Navy base as filters, relief and correlation, and we used the PSO to compare it with the proposed algorithms. As you can see in the table to the side, for above bases that using the complete base, that is the presence of redundant, irrelevant, or noise filters, which influences the performance of the classifier. This is notable due to the performance of the Navy based classifier, as correlating features affect negatively, size it x independently, as can also be verified for the SVM classifier, which with the complete database has very, very low accuracy when compared after the subsets of selected features. What may have happened for the accuracy to be so slow initially? Was the use of the database that can be overlapping class due to database imbalance for the proposed approach? We can see that there was verified big improvement in accuracy when compared to the complete base, né, no selection. However, when we compare each other GAC and GAIP, we can see that the GAIP approach has a better performance. The GAIP approach performs better when comparing the RAP approach using the genetic algorithm and PSO. And so I end my presentation. Thanks for attention.
Okay, thank you. any question? We have one in the chat. And say, usually genetic algorithms are computationally expensive, in time consuming, How you address this problem in your approach? How long was the experimentation? Was the optimization process in your experiments? Yeah. Johnny?
I don't understand.
The question is about the time, the running time of your experiments. How was it?
Maybe I can help with that as well. Thank you, Robert, for your question. So our goal for this specific project was to use GA for feature extraction, feature selection. So we understand and we accept that GAs are expensive, but we wanted to see if they could, you know, select better features than the standard filters and wrappers models that have been used before in the literature. Surprisingly, because this data set is not very large, we didn't have major issues regarding the optimization process. So the GA would run for, you know, not days or even hours. The GA would run for a few minutes and then would select the best solutions. But we completely understand that if we have larger data sets, that would be a big issue. But yeah, we managed to, you know, show that we could use GAs for feature selection, which in theory wouldn't necessarily, you know, impact if these features are used in a classifier somewhere else, because they would be selected beforehand. So this would be done offline. Okay, I hope I answer your question. You are on mute, Ricardo.
Thank you. Robert says thank you too. Any other question? Okay. Thank you to you both for the presentation.